Hey, welcome back, everybody. And I hate to start things this way, but we've got some disturbing news. The corn syrup wars are brewing. Controversy over last month's Super Bowl ad from Bud Light shaming Miller Lite and Coors Light for using corn syrup is now headed to court.
MTN's Russell Nemet shares more in our Montana Ag Network feature.
Miller Coors has filed a lawsuit against Anheuser-Busch InBev, seeking an immediate halt to the campaign. Miller Coors media relations manager Marty Maloney says it's false advertising meant to deceive customers and misuses the Miller and Coors trademarks.
You know, we've always believed in transparency, which is why we were actually the first major brewer to put nutritional information in all of our ingredients online. It's fear-mongering over a common beer ingredient it uses in many of its own beers and as a fermentation aid that's not even present in the final product. So this deliberate deception is bad for the entire beer category, and we just want to let the world know the truth.
He says several factors played into their decision to sue Anheuser-Busch.
One, the farming and agriculture community is rightfully very upset. Two, their sales have declined at an accelerated rate. And three, they can't keep their story straight on why they launched this campaign to begin with, which I think speaks to our original point, which is they were, from the outset, they were out there to mislead and stoke fear in consumers.
Montana farmers raise barley for both Miller Coors and Anheuser-Busch. And as both of these beer giants head to court, Miller Coors seeks an injunction to stop Anheuser-Busch from continuing the ad campaign and is asking for a trial by jury and for defendants to pay its legal fees. Meanwhile, in a statement to CNN, Anheuser-Busch said it stands by its Bud Light ad campaign and called the Miller Coors lawsuit baseless. In Billings, Russell Nemitz, MTN News.
Now, the Miller Coors Company alleges that Bud Light singled out its use of corn syrup because it found using focus groups that consumers don't understand the difference between corn syrup and high fructose corn syrup, which has been linked to obesity.